I'm sorry, Ellie, I didn't catch that. What was that? Welcome to Explore Kids Online. What have you got there? You've got a mouth. Okay, hello. This is actually the craft that we're going to be doing at the end of today's video. So we'll be showing you how to do that a little bit later on. But welcome to today's video where we are talking about our words and the way that we should use our words and the way that we should use our ability to speak. Okay, so Ellie, can you... I know, your ability to speak. All right, so Ellie, can you please, can you give us some examples of some good ways that we can use our words?
You can say friendly stuff, encouraging stuff, and you can tell the truth, or you can give advice. And something you could say if you're on the phone or you're meeting a friend or something is, how are you?
Fantastic, yeah. I love the encouraging one and the how are you. How brilliant is that? Right, okay. But the problem is that just in the same way as you can use your words for good things, you can use your words for bad things. Give us a couple of examples of things. You don't want to say things. All right. Is that going to be me then? Okay. Well, okay. Well, for example, you can tell lies, can't you? If you can tell the truth, then you can also sadly use your words to tell lies. We're not suggesting that you should be doing any of these things. In fact, this whole video is about how you shouldn't be doing these bad things. But you can also be nasty and make fun of people and say mean things to people. That's not a good way to use our words, but it's a way that people do use their words, use their ability to speak. And finally, of course, using swear words and bad language is another example of how people can use their words in not a very good way. And I'm going to tell you a story right now, which is all about how a couple of people use their words for very, very bad things, and one person in particular used his words for things that were very, very good. So are you ready? Here we go. Here come some pictures. So it's the story of Nehemiah. Now, Nehemiah was the cupbearer to the king. You can hardly see my face. Let me scooch over a bit. Nehemiah, that's better. Nehemiah was the cupbearer to the king of Persia, but he came from Israel. He came from Jerusalem. He was a Jew, and he got some very bad news. He was told about how back in his own country, the walls of the city had been broken down and damaged. Now, this was a very, very bad news for a city, because walls were very important for keeping the city safe. And so he wondered what on earth to do, and he was very sad, and he got talking to the king, and the king gave him permission to go back and rebuild the walls of Jerusalem, which was very kind and very, very exciting. And so Nehemiah went back there, and he told everybody exactly what they needed to do to start rebuilding the walls. He got everybody working, and it wasn't long before they'd started rebuilding those walls. And look, don't they look as if they are working really, really, really hard? And everybody is just so excited that the walls are going to be fixed and the walls are going to be much, much, much better. But the problem was, there were some people that didn't like it, because the Jewish people, they had enemies at that time. And one such enemy was a guy called Sanballat, strange name, and the other guy was a guy called Tobiah. And they're the guys that in today's story use their words for really, really bad things. Let me give you some examples, but let me bring up a picture first of all of Sanballat. There he is. And Sanballat, he's sort of saying, oh, the very first thing that they did, the very first bad thing that they did with their words was to accuse. When you accuse somebody, you tell say that they're doing something wrong. And actually, we accuse in court and all that kind of stuff, and it's not so bad. But when we make accusations that we don't actually know, it's a very, very bad thing indeed. And so he came up, and he would have known the answer to this, really, but he came up and said, "Oi, Nehemiah, are you rebelling against the king? We're going to get you into trouble. Is that what you're doing? That's what we're doing." And he started to accuse Nehemiah of all kinds of things. And Nehemiah says, "No, we have the king's permission, as you well know, and we are going to build the walls." The next thing, the next bad use of words that Sanballat and Tobiah had was they started insulting them and saying nasty things to them. So
does he actually have bluey green hair?
I don't think so. No, it is a bit kind of like
it's
different.
Cool.
Yeah. So Sanballat started by saying, "Oh, what a waste of time. Do they really think that they're going to succeed?" And he was saying it as loud as he could so everybody could hear. "Do they really think that they're going to succeed? Do they really think they'll get these walls built again? Do they really think that they'll get their temple working again and start worshipping God properly? There, we don't believe that. It's just a load of rubbish. They are wasting their time." And then, oh, I need to get rid of that one. Hang on. Get rid of that picture. They still built that. I brought that up. They still were still building all of this time, by the way. And then Tobiah, he joins in. There's Tobiah. Tobiah joins in and he's saying, "You know what? I think that wall's rubbish. I think you are just rubbish at building. And I think even if a fox was to start walking across the top of your wall, it would make the wall fall down. Because I think your wall is so rubbish and so badly built. And it's absolutely rubbish. But you know what?" Nehemiah says, "We are not listening to your insults. We are not paying attention to what you say and all of the bad, nasty things that you're saying to us. We are going to keep building our wall." Oh, so Tobiah and Sanballat went back away, having not accomplished that. But then the third bad way that they used their words was they decided to, oh, hang on, I still need that picture up. Oh. They decided to start threatening. "Right, if you don't stop building that wall, we're going to get our friends, we're going to get our armies, and we're going to come and we're going to fight against you to stop you." So again, so we've looked.
Terrible.
I know, bad ways that we can use our words. So we've had accusations. We've had insults and saying nasty things, and we've had threats, threatening people, and not a very good thing to do at all. What's this next picture? It is what I thought. Because the fourth bad use of words actually wasn't from Sanballat and Tobiah, but it was as a result of the threats that they'd made. Because the people of Israel, Judah, that were building the wall, came to Nehemiah and they said, "We're just too tired. We can't be bothered anymore. It's too much rubble. It's too much like hard work. We don't want to do it anymore. And besides which, you've heard what they've said, Sanballat and Tobiah. If we carry on building this wall, they'll come and attack us. Oh, we don't want to do this anymore. It's all going wrong. We don't like it." And they were moaning and they were whinging and they were complaining and they were being really, really negative, and saying some really unhelpful things. And that's the fourth bad use of our words, to moan and complain and whinge and be negative. We don't want to do that. We want to use our words for good things. It's a good job. It's a good job that Nehemiah was there. And Nehemiah says, look. Let's make a plan. Yeah? Mm-hmm. You're feeling tired. You feel it's hard work. Well, we don't want to give up, but let's make a plan. Let's get our heads together. Let's think about how we're going to fix this problem and what we're going to do. So that's the first thing that he did. Second thing that he did was to say, look, don't worry about these people's threats. Remember, we've got God on our side. God will help us. God will look after us. God will keep us safe and he'll protect us. So in other words, what was Nehemiah doing? He was using his words for a good thing. He was using his words to encourage. And it wasn't long before all of the builders, all of the guys started building again and were really excited and happy again. And it wasn't long before the walls were finished. The wall was finished and everybody was really excited and they hadn't been stopped. Nothing had stopped them. Not even the fifth bad use of words, which comes in the story, by the way. And that is that Sanballat and Tobiah and the others started making up stories about Nehemiah. They started spreading stories that he was trying to become the king. And that he was trying to make himself all important. And that they started telling all of these untrue stories about him. They started telling lies, and the worst kind of lies, when you tell lies about people, it's called slander. It's a terrible, terrible, terrible thing to be doing. And but even that didn't stop the builders, and they finished the wall, and they were all really, really happy. You see, as we've said, you can use your words in good ways and you can use your words in bad ways. We have to actually think about the words that we say and the things that we're going to say. So before you speak, think. Is it true? T for true. Is it
helpful? H for helpful.
Yeah. Is it inspiring? In other words, is it going to make people feel good about themselves? Mm. Encouraging might be another way that you could say that, but then it would be think, not think. N, is it necessary? Sometimes you have to say things to people which you know they might not want to hear, okay? But actually, you can do so gently and you can do so kindly. But you have to ask the question, is it necessary? Do I really need to say this? And sometimes you might have had people say things to you and there was no need for them to say that. It didn't actually help matters.
And you don't say anything because they might take it wrong.
Yeah, and you're just like, does it really matter? So is it necessary? So is it true? Is it helpful? Is it inspiring? Is it necessary? And we've already mentioned the last one, K for kind. Is it kind? Are you being kind? Even if you are saying something that's a little bit difficult, you can still do it kindly and gently, like a good friend. Shall we have a song about words?
Yeah.
Here we go then. Let's get rid of that and play and press that.
They've made me feel like a prisoner. They've made me feel set free. They've made me feel like a criminal. Made me feel like a king. They've lifted my heart to places I've never been. And they've dragged me down back to where. Is the only thing we need to hear.
Where's Ellie gone? Where's she gone now? Hey, where's she gone? Oh, there she is. Right. Oh, there was, so there was a song all about the things that we've been saying, how we can use our words for bad or we can use our words for good. We can help people or we can hurt people. We can encourage people or we can harm people and discourage people and make them feel bad about themselves. And that's not what we want to do. We want to use our words for good. And I trust that that's what we're going to do. And it's time to make our craft for today. And can you just see on that craft, written on the top part of the mouth there, true,
helpful, inspiring, needed, and kind.
And needed and kind. I put needed instead of necessary because it's shorter.
Just easier.
But, and it's easier. But, you know, it's, you know, so this is going to be a reminder of the kind of ways that we should use our words. So, first thing to do, Ellie, before you start cutting, let me explain. I thought this was a simple. You need two pieces of paper, okay? Actually, you need a piece of sort of pinky ready paper, if you've got it. Pink in this case. And you need a piece of card. Now, the card could be... Well, the card could be any colour because it's going to be at the back. But what I've done, you might notice, is I've put them together and then I folded them together. So the pink is inside the piece of white card.
Did you stick them?
And?
Did you stick
I did. I haven't stuck them, actually. No. You could actually stick them first. Should we do that?
Yeah.
Let's stick them first. Okay. So, what's happened to that? Okay. Never mind. Anyway, so we'll put glue all over here. I tell you why I didn't stick them.
Why?
Because it's easier to cut when you're not cutting through the glue.
I like cutting through the glue.
It might be a bit more difficult. And it's, but anyway, we've done it now. Either way, whether you cut them first and then stick them together, or whether you stick them together and then you cut. Can you put the top back on that for me, please?
Yep.
Okay. So, and then you pop it back together. This just means that by doing this, you'll just make sure that you're cutting it all both the same. There you go. So, Ellie,
mm-hmm.
You're going to cut. Show them the shapes that they need to cut. So that kind of shape. So, Ellie, are you going to do that?
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay, so cutting that kind of shape. Brilliant.
It's a bit uneven.
It looks good to me. There we go. So we've got that cut. Now, so you open it up.
And you have service.
So, oh, yeah. So if you open it up, there you've got the inside of your mouth. Now, of course, you need some teeth and you need a tongue.
Where's
so
the white paper?
So you need some, well, let's do the tongue first.
Ooh.
The tongue, you need a piece of red paper, or if you haven't got that, like I haven't got any red paper, I've just printed a red
or
page off
just
of the thingy.
Colour plain one.
Or you could colour it in. Actually, that would be better because you wouldn't be using loads of computer ink then. So I'm going to just cut a tongue shape out, okay? And then again, we want to glue that inside, okay?
I need the example.
Yeah, so glue that inside. And then you want some teeth. And to cut the teeth, it's really, really simple, okay? Actually, Elle, let me just put that so that they can see what you're doing there.
This glue won't work.
The glue's, it's not much good. Always make sure you get a better glue stick than we've got here. Than we've got here. This is on its way out. No. We're on now, aren't we? We're just going to have to make do. We'll still get enough sticky out of it, I'm sure. Okay, to cope. So stick that on there, like that. Okay, it's not stuck particularly well, but you get the idea.
We have a terrible glue.
You get the idea. And then obviously you want to make a nice, you need to draw a little line down the middle so that it actually looks like, it doesn't matter.
Black.
Doesn't matter. She's going to go and get black. Okay. While she's getting black, she draws a nice a line down the middle that's going to be like that one there.
But not all the way okay. down, because that would just look like you're splitting.
Yeah, that just looks as if you cut your tongue off in half. Right. And then to get a little strip of white paper like this, okay, to make the teeth with. So you simply cut little squares.
The
there they are.
You can't see it, do you?
Let's get rid of that bit of paper there that we've been using. Yeah. Okay. You cut this. Cut the. Cut little squares. And.
I need a better glue.
And then you stick those around the outside, like I have done here at the top, and there at the bottom. Okay. So do you want to do that, Ellie?
Do you want to do the chicken?
If I put the glue on.
I can't use this glue.
Okay, well, it's actually a bit simpler. I'm just going to stick a few teeth on this one because we haven't got much time left. Our time has gone. Do you know, I started off telling that story thinking it was going to be a really quick one. And then it ended up not being. But it was a very important story because, as we said before, we need to use our words for good. So I'm just going to stick a few teeth in. Okay. Let me just let you see what I'm doing. Okay, so I'm going to stick a few teeth in there. Okay, and a few teeth in the top.
But you have more time at home.
You've got more time at home, so you can stick more teeth in if you want to. What are you going to do? Ah, you're going to write the words. So you're writing. Remember, our words are true, helpful. Fungus, get past you. There we go. True, helpful, inspiring. Necessary or needed is what I wrote, and kind. And if we can ask ourselves the question whenever we are going to say something to somebody, and ask ourselves the question as to whether those things are true about what we're going to be saying, then we can be a bit more confident about saying it. And knowing that we're not going to just upset people or be nasty. But actually, if it's not kind, we shouldn't say it. If it's not true, we shouldn't say it. If it's not helpful, we shouldn't say it. If it's not going to make somebody feel good about themselves, maybe not straight. And sometimes the things we say doesn't make them necessarily feel good about themselves straight away, but it does make them feel good about themselves later when you've helped them. And etc. If our words are like are good like that, then they'll do people a lot of good, and we'll help people and we'll encourage people, and that will be fantastic. Okay, how are we doing? Brilliant. Okay, so our time is more or less up. Do you want to show them what you've done so far?
Two more
then, because unfortunately our time has gone. Show them what you're doing. Ellie started writing the words on there in really, really, really creative writing there. Love it. Of course, what you could do is you could get little bits of paper of different colours and stick them in and write the words on those and stick them inside, or maybe stick them around the outside somehow. You could do that as well. Lots and lots of different ideas that you can do. The important thing is that you've got something there to help you to remember to use your words in a good way. Let's pray and then we'll finish our video together. Father God, thank you for our words. Thank you that they can build people up and help people. And that's what we want to use our words for. So we pray, Lord God, for the ability to think very, very carefully and for your help to use our words to, for good things and not for bad things. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
Fantastic. We will see you later for another Explore Kids Online video. Bye. Say bye, Ellie.
Bye.
Bye. Use your words. See you later.